The SIU Medicine Minute brought to you by SIU School of Medicine.
Welcome back to your SIU Medicine Minute. Joining me today is Dr. John Flack of Internal Medicine, specifically dealing with hypertension. Dr. Flack, thanks so much for joining us today. We really appreciate it.
Thank you.
So what qualifies as someone having hypertension, and how would they know that they do have hypertension?
Typically, people go get a cuff put on their arm, hopefully their bare arm under the right conditions, that tells us what the pressure is at peak. That's the top number, the systolic, and at rest in diastole, the bottom number. And when the top number is 130 or higher, the bottom number is 80 or higher, consistently over time, they have hypertension.
Other than taking medication, what can people do to help prevent their risks of getting hypertension?
Well, if they do have it, certainly take their medicine, plus do these other things. Dietary sodium restriction or reduction. Sodium is in the food mostly before we see it, and trying to avoid high sodium foods like breads, soup, pizza, fast foods, processed meats, and not adding at least much during preparation or at the table. Aerobic exercise, even resistance exercise helps, but aerobic exercise is better. Weight loss, which is difficult to accomplish and has a variable effect on blood pressure, is also good. And finally, men do not have more than 2 mixed drinks a day, women not more than 1.
And finally, Dr. Flack, what are some of the groups that are especially at higher risk for developing hypertension?
Well, in the United States, firstly, every demographic group develops hypertension, the vast majority by the time they leave the earth. There are some groups who develop it sooner rather than later. U.S. blacks, people who are overweight, people with diabetes, people with chronic kidney disease where kidneys don't filter their blood and all and take the toxins out. People who are very sedentary, who sit around in office jobs and high stress areas and eat and gain weight. Those people will develop high blood pressure sooner rather than later.
So eat right, be fit, make healthy choices, and don't be sedentary. The bottom line to this, correct?
That's great packaged advice.
Dr. John Flack, SIU Internal Medicine, dealing with hypertension. Thanks so much for joining us today. We really appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thanks for watching the SIU Medicine Minute. For more information, visit our website at siumed.org.